So we'll start with the mechanical properties of solids today. And first of all, elasticity and definitions of various terms. So deforming force, so any body, so it can be, deformed by applying some external force. So force which is required to change the shape and size of a material is known as deforming force. So external force which try to change the length, volume or shape of a material is known as deforming force. Okay. So just say you have this body and you are applying a force in this direction so that its length, which was initially L, has been increased by delta L. So this external force is basically the deforming force. And there will be a resistive force which will resist the change in its shape, that is the internal force. So elasticity is that property of a body by virtue of which the body opposes any change in its shape or size when deforming forces are applied to it and recover its original state as soon as the deforming forces are removed. So elasticity is a property of a body. What it does, what that property is about, body opposing any change in its shape or size. So whenever a deforming force is applied, the body, the inherent property of the body will be to change, will be to resist the change which is being brought by these deforming forces. So that inherent property is elasticity of that body. So, so deforming forces are applied to it and recover its original state. So when the moment you stop applying this deforming force, that is external force, the body will again come back to its original shape. So ye jo internal force hai jo ki isko wapas apne original shape mein lata hai, that property is known as elasticity. Perfectly elastic body, the body which perfectly regains its original form on removing the external deforming force, is defined as perfectly elastic body. So if a body perfectly regains its original form, so whatever length was there, we have changed the length by an external force or deforming force. When we remove the deforming force, if the body comes back to its original shape and size, then we say that this body is perfectly elastic. So very near example of a perfectly elastic body is quads. Generally 100% elastic kuch bhi nahi hota hai, but very near to perfectly elastic body is quads. Plastic body, the bodies which remain in deformed state even after removal of the deforming force. So when you apply a deforming force, if the body remain at its deformed shape only, that body is known as plastic body. So there are two kind of bodies. One is elastic and other is plastic. So elastic when it comes back to its original shape and size, plastic when it remains at the same shape and size which the deforming force brings to it. The plastic body does not have the property of opposing the external deforming force. So there is no internal force which opposes this external deforming force. And that's why it remains in the same deformed shape. Restoring force, so ye jo elasticity is caused by this restoring force. So on deformation, intermolecular force is set up in the body, which tends to bring the original configuration of body. That force is called restoring force, the intermolecular force, which tries to bring back the body to its original configuration is known as restoring force. When body is deformed by some external force, intermolecular distances changes, right? So when we deform a body by applying some external force, the distance between the molecules changes, that increases if we are stretching it, and that decreases when we are compressing it. So intermolecular forces opposes this change and try to bring the body to original state. So when we try to change the intermolecular distances, the intermolecular forces opposes this change and tries to bring the body to original shape, state. Now stress, The definition of stress is the internal restoring force acting per unit area of cross section of deformed body is called stress. So basically, internal restoring force acting per unit area. So stress ka definition, if we see, stress is equal to restoring force by area. Restoring force ko F internal kare, F internal divided by area. So F internal is basically internal restoring force. So at equilibrium, when the body is at equilibrium, the internal resistance force is equal to external deforming force. Stress is equal to, so when at equilibrium, we can also say that stress is equal to external deforming force by area. Why? Because external deforming force and internal restoring forces are equal. SI unit of stress, see, this is force by area. So Newton per meter square, SI unit is Newton per meter square for stress. Stress is not a vector quantity, since unlike a force, the stress cannot be assigned a particular direction, specific direction. Stress is not produced due to deforming force. So deforming force is responsible for strain. Okay. So stress is not produced due to deforming force. Deforming force is responsible for strain. Stress is produced by internal restoring force. It is the restoring force which causes stress. So if restoring force is absent, material will be easily deformed and almost no stress will be produced. Stress can be broadly classified into two types. So this is normal stress and shear stress. So there are two kinds of stresses. One is called normal stress and other is called shear stress. So when force is perpendicular to surface under consideration, then stress is said to be normal stress. So if this is the surface and the force applied is in this direction, which is perpendicular to the surface, then we say that this force will produce normal stress. So it can further be divided into two parts. One is longitudinal stress and other is hydrostatic or volume stress. So normal stress ke do types hai, longitudinal stress and hydrostatic stress. So first we'll see longitudinal stress, right? So basically we have normal stress is of two types. One is longitudinal stress. And other is hydrostatic stress. So one is normal stress and other is hydrostatic stress. Now, longitudinal stress, stress produced in a body due to change in length is called longitudinal stress. So let F internal is restoring force perpendicular to the surface of area A when length of the body is increased. Longitudinal stress is F internal upon area. Now there are two types of longitudinal stresses. Okay. First is tensile stress and other is compressive stress. So the longitudinal stress produced due to increase in length of a body is called a tensile stress. And compressive stress, the longitudinal stress produced due to decrease in length of the body. So this is due to increase in length, and due to decrease in length, the stress produced is compressive stress. Okay. Now, so longitudinal stress again is of two types. One is tensile stress and the other is compressive stress. So when material is under tensile stress, the restoring force are caused by intermolecular attraction, while under compressive stress, the restoring force are due to intermolecular repulsion. Okay. So a compressive stress may internal force will be opposite in this direction. And in case of tensile stress, internal forces is in this direction. Now let us do this question. The ratio of radii of two wires of same material is, if same material is 2:1. So R1 by R2 is equal to 2 by 1. If these wires are stressed by equal forces, then the ratio of stresses produced in them, so stress 1 upon stress 2 is equal to, forces are equal, F by pi R1 square divided by F by pi R2 square. F gone, pi pi gone. So this is R2 by R1 ka whole square. 1 by 2 ka whole square, that is 1 by 4. Or ratio is 1 is to 4. Option 3. Is it clear?
Yes, sir.
Now, volume stress is also known as bulk stress or hydrostatic stress. तो हम लोगों ने देखा था दो तरीके का नॉर्मल स्ट्रेस होता है, एक लॉन्गिट्यूडनल स्ट्रेस होता है, दूसरा वॉल्यूम स्ट्रेस होता है. तो वॉल्यूम स्ट्रेस, इफ सिमेट्रिकल कंप्रेसिव एंड नॉर्मल फोर्सेस आर अप्लाइड ऑन अ सरफेस ऑफ अ बॉडी, देन इट अंडरगोज चेंज इन वॉल्यूम. द फोर्स अपोजिंग दिस चेंज इन वॉल्यूम पर यूनिट एरिया इज डिफाइंड एज वॉल्यूम स्ट्रेस. ओके, सो कंसिडर अ बॉडी इज सराउंडेड बाय अ फ्लूइड having exerting pressure P on the body. So then change in pressure delta P is treated as bulk stress. Okay. So we are applying these forces. Now on application of these forces, the volume. So volume decreases by an amount delta V. So initial volume was V and it has decreased by, let's say, delta V on application of the pressure P. Now, तो वहां पे जो change in pressure delta P था, that is treated as bulk stress. Previous case में जो change in pressure है delta P, this is treated as bulk stress. Now shear stress, तो हम लोगों ने दो तरीके का स्ट्रेस देखा था, एक नॉर्मल स्ट्रेस और एक शियर स्ट्रेस, राइट. सो नॉर्मल स्ट्रेस वहां पे सरफेस के परपेंडिकुलर जब हम फोर्स लगाते हैं, दैट वाज नॉर्मल स्ट्रेस, और जब सरफेस के टेंजेंशियल में फोर्स लगाएंगे उसको शियर स्ट्रेस कहते हैं. सो व्हेनेवर देयर इज अ रिलेटिव डिस्प्लेसमेंट ऑफ सक्सेसिव लेयर्स ऑफ अ सॉलिड, अ रीस्टोरिंग फोर्स इज सेट अप पैरेलल टू द सरफेस. तो यहाँ पे रीस्टोरिंग फोर्स इज पैरेलल टू द सरफेस. देयर द रीस्टोर इन नॉर्मल स्ट्रेस द रीस्टोरिंग फोर्स वॉज परपेंडिकुलर टू द सरफेस. सो दिस इज द डिफरेंस बिटवीन शियर स्ट्रेस एंड नॉर्मल स्ट्रेस. सो नॉर्मल का मतलब ये परपेंडिकुलर है ना, तो वहां पे ऐसे याद रख सकते हो कि नॉर्मल स्ट्रेस इज परपेंडिकुलर टू द सरफेस, द रीस्टोरिंग फोर्स देयर इज परपेंडिकुलर टू द सरफेस, एंड इन शियर स्ट्रेस द रीस्टोरिंग फोर्स इज पैरेलल टू द सरफेस. नाउ when we talk about shear stress is restoring force parallel to the surface, restoring force parallel to the surface divided by area of surface. ठीक है, so this is known as shear stress. तो यहाँ पे restoring force, मान लो F force लगा रहे हैं और ये वाला surface fixed है, so the bottom surface is fixed. So when the top surface have been moved by some amount, right? So it has moved by some distance. So this restoring force applied on this will be equal to this only in equilibrium, equal to deforming force. So force by area of surface will give you shear stress. The shear stress is measure of opposition offered by a body to change in its shape. Comparison of pressure and stress. तो generally लोगों को लग सकता है कि भाई force by area यहाँ पे भी है, pressure में भी उसका यूनिट देखोगे न्यूटन पर मीटर स्क्वायर, बिकॉज फोर्स अपॉन एरिया है, और स्ट्रेस में भी न्यूटन पर मीटर स्क्वायर, ये भी फोर्स अपॉन एरिया है. बट व्हेन यू कंपेयर इट, प्रेशर इज ऑलवेज नॉर्मल टू द एरिया, वेयर एज स्ट्रेस कैन बी आइदर नॉर्मल और टेंजेंशियल. सो दिस इज फर्स्ट डिफरेंस, दैट प्रेशर विल ऑलवेज बी नॉर्मल टू द सर्फेस, बट stress can be either normal or tangential. Okay. Second is, pressure on a body is always compressive, whereas stress can be compressive or tensile or shear. So, the pressure on a body is always compressive, okay? But whereas stress can be compressive or tensile or shear, in all three forms it can be. So this is the difference between pressure and stress. Now, strain. So, strain is basically change in size of the body divided by its original size. Okay, so there are, if I talk about longitudinal strain, the change in size is change in length. So delta L divided by original size means L. So delta by L by L gives you longitudinal strain, if you can see here as well. The form of strain depends upon the direction of applied force. And jo strain hai, uska form depend karega ki direction kis direction mein ye force lag raha hai, deforming force. There are three types of strain. Strain is a unitless and dimensionless quantity. Why? Because it, you know, size upon size. So this is basically same physical quantity in numerator and denominator both. So the units cancel, and hence strain is a unitless and dimensionless quantity. Now, longitudinal strain is measure of relative change in length of a body. So if you see the formula of longitudinal strain is change in length of the body by original length. So if we have this body whose length is L and you are applying a deforming force F, the internal restoring force is acted in this direction. So because of this force, deforming force, the length has been increased by an amount delta L, let us suppose. Then a longitudinal strain will be change in length by original length. Now, length is generally defined for solids only. Okay, therefore, longitudinal strain is defined for solids only. It is meaningless to define longitudinal strain for liquids and gases. Now, volumetric strain, longitudinal strain is measure of relative change in length of a body. Okay, so volumetric strain, change in volume of the body by its original volume will give you volumetric strain. Okay, so let V is the volume of the body, delta V is change in volume of the body, then volumetric strain is given by delta V upon V. So if we are applying this stress, normal stress from all these directions, so volumetric stress lag raha hai, let's say hydrostatic stress, to uske wajah se iska volume is decreasing by delta V, then volumetric strain will be delta V by V, means change in volume by original volume. Now, shear strain. So, shear strain is measure of change in shape of a body. Okay. So we have seen longitudinal strain. We have seen volumetric strain, delta V by V. Now, shear strain is measure of change in shape of a body. So, when deforming forces act in a manner that there is a relative displacement of interatomic planes, shape of a body change. Figure below shows two forces acting parallel to the surface responsible for changing the shape of the body. These forces are shear forces. So, हम लोगों ने इसको fix कर रखा है और एक force top surface पे लगा रहे हैं. तो उसके वजह से क्या है? इसका shape change कर रहा है. Let's say this this surface, top surface, has moved by a distance L, right? Let's say the length between these two surfaces is capital L. The angle by which it is moved in, you know, in this direction, right direction, is phi. Okay, this length is L. Now, the force applied here is F. Now, shear strain may be defined as angular displacement of surface perpendicular to the applied surface. So, phi is actually the shear strain. So, L is equal to displacement. So, basically, hume pata hai for small angle phi, tan phi is approximately equal to phi. So, if phi is small, tan phi is approximately equal to phi, which will be equal to perpendicular by base, that is small L by capital L. That means L, if it is very, very less than capital L, hai na? This distance by which this has moved towards right, the surface has moved towards right, if it is very, very less than this distance, capital L, then in that case, the phi will be equal to small L by capital N. Shear strain phi is displacement of upper surface by distance between two faces, which is equal to small L upon capital L. Is it clear?
Yes, sir.
Now, the third example, figure shows a cylindrical rod of area of cross section A. Its upper end is fixed while its lower end is fixed while upper end is free. Force F acts on free surface at angle theta with the vertical. Find longitudinal stress across free surface. So, dekho, F ke do component honge. Ek idhar hoga F sine theta aur is direction mein hoga F cos theta. Longitudinal stress is being provided by this perpendicular.
Okay.
So longitudinal stress is equal to perpendicular force by area. So this is F cos theta upon A. And if we have to find the shear stress, shear stress is equal to F parallel upon A. Parallel component is F sine theta upon A.
Excuse me, sir.
Yes.
Sir, if we had to find shear strain, then
shear strain ke liye fir ye diya hua hona chahiye tha na ki ye kitne
distance. L ye diya hona chahiye tha.
ये दिया होना चाहिए था कि ये ऐसे मूव करके यहाँ पहुंच गया है, तो ये स्मॉल एल दिया होता तो हम लोग स्मॉल एल
एल अपॉन कैपिटल एल कर देते हैं. ओके सर.
नाउ स्ट्रेस स्ट्रेन कर्व एंड डेफिनेशन. सो स्ट्रेस स्ट्रेन कर्व ये काफी important hai in terms of the theoretical questions aate hain kabhi kabhi. So the relationship between stress and strain in a wire is illustrated by the graphs shown below. So if by gradually increasing the load on a vertically suspended metal wire a graph is plotted between stress and longitudinal strain, we get the curve as shown in the figure below. To agar hum log yahan pe ek wire ke par ek load ko हम लोग बढ़ाते जाए तो उस लोड को बढ़ाते जाने से है ना ऑन अ वर्टिकल सस्पेंडेड ये मेटल वायर पे हम लोग लोड बढ़ा रहे हैं. सो उसको बढ़ाने से हम लोग को ये स्ट्रेस स्ट्रेन कर्व मिलेगा है ना. हर मोमेंट पे हम लोग स्ट्रेस और स्ट्रेन मेजर करेंगे और उसको प्लॉट करेंगे तो वी विल गेट दिस कर्व. ठीक है. ग्राफ इज प्लॉटेड बिटवीन स्ट्रेस और लोड एंड लॉन्गिट्यूडनल स्ट्रेन और इलांगेशन. वी गेट द कर्व एज शोन in the figure below above. From this curve it is clear that when the strain is small, that is less than 2%, that is in the region OA, स्ट्रेस इज प्रोपोर्शनल टू स्ट्रेंथ. तो फ्रॉम रीजंस इनिशियली क्या है, जैसे जैसे आप स्ट्रेस को इंक्रीज करोगे स्ट्रेन भी है ना इंक्रीज करता जाएगा एंड दिस विल बी अ लीनियर रिलेशन. सो इन द रीजन OA वी से दैट स्ट्रेस इज डायरेक्टली प्रोपोर्शनल टू स्ट्रेन, राइट. सो दिस इज द रीजन वेयर हुक्स लॉ इज ओबेड, है ना. हम लोग अभी पढ़ेंगे भी यंग्स मॉडुलस y इज इक्वल टू स्ट्रेस अपॉन स्ट्रेन होता है. सो स्ट्रेस अपॉन स्ट्रेन इज इक्वल टू कॉन्स्टेंट, दिस इज वॉट हुक्स लॉ स्टेट्स. तो स्ट्रेस अपॉन स्ट्रेन इज कॉन्स्टेंट, मतलब स्ट्रेस इज प्रोपोर्शनल टू स्ट्रेन, एक ही बात है. तो ये लीनियर जो रिलेशन होगा ये कब तक होगा, जहां तक कि हुक्स लॉ इज बींग ओबेड. सो पॉइंट ए इज कॉल्ड लिमिट ऑफ प्रोपोर्शनैलिटी. तो यहां तक प्रोपोर्शनल है, इसीलिए इसको पॉइंट ए को लिमिट ऑफ प्रोपोर्शनैलिटी, इसके आगे प्रोपोर्शनल नहीं है, है ना, लीनियर रिलेशन नहीं है, कर्व में बदल जाता है. तो ओ से लेके ए तक लीनियर रिलेशन है, इसीलिए इसको हम लोग इस ए पॉइंट को लिमिट ऑफ प्रोपोर्शनैलिटी कहते हैं. स्लोप ऑफ लाइन ओ ए गिव्स द यंग्स मॉडुलस, जब स्ट्रेस अपॉन स्ट्रेन हम लोग कह रहे हैं, ये जो टैन थीटा क्या होगा, स्ट्रेस अपॉन स्ट्रेन विच इज स्लोप. सो स्लोप ऑफ ओ ए इज इक्वल टू टैन थीटा, दैट इज स्ट्रेस अपॉन स्ट्रेन विच इज इक्वल टू यंग्स मॉडुलस. तो स्लोप ऑफ द लाइन ओ ए गिव्स द यंग्स मॉडुलस वाई ऑफ द मटेरियल ऑफ द वायर. इफ थीटा इज द एंगल ऑफ ओ ए फ्रॉम स्ट्रेन एक्सिस देन वाई इज इक्वल टू टैन थीटा. सो बेसिकली ये जो y इज इक्वल टू टेन थीटा हो गया, यंग्स मॉडुलस इज इक्वल टू टेन थीटा. जब स्ट्रेस स्ट्रेन कर्व दिया होगा तो सीधे स्लोप निकाल लेंगे, तो उससे हम लोग को यंग्स मॉडुलस का वैल्यू पता चल जाता है. अब इन द रीजन ए बी द स्ट्रेस इज नॉट प्रोपोर्शनल टू स्ट्रेन. तो ये रीजन में स्ट्रेस इज नॉट प्रोपोर्शनल टू स्ट्रेन, बट wire still regains its original length after the removal of stretching force. So wire still exhibits elastic behavior up to point B. So beyond B, wire shows plastic behavior. So point B is called yield point, and stress corresponding to this point is called elastic limit or yielding stress. So B point, A point proportionality limit tha, B point elastic limit hai. Iske aage elasticity khatam ho jati hai, wo plastic region chala jata hai, hai na? तो ये जो पूरा रीजन है इसके इधर, ये पूरा रीजन फ्रॉम हियर टू,
एक्सक्यूज मी सर,
ये
सर क्वार्ट में ये एबी रीजन बहुत एक्सटेंड कर जाता होगा.
हाँ, एबी रीजन ही नहीं, ओ ए बी पूरा, ये पूरा रीजन आगे एक्सटेंड करता आगे तक ना, ठीक है, बहुत दूर तक तो यही रहेगा, बस एबी ही नहीं ओ ए भी इंक्रीज कर जाता है और एबी भी इंक्रीज कर जाता है, दोनों इंक्रीज कर जाता. इन द रीजन ओ ए बी वायर शोज इलास्टिक बिहेवियर, राइट. सो ओ से लेके बी तक दिस होल रीजन इज इलास्टिक रीजन, दिस होल रीजन. नाउ इफ द वायर इज स्ट्रेस्ड बियॉन्ड द इलास्टिक लिमिट, सो बियॉन्ड द इलास्टिक लिमिट इफ यू स्ट्रेस दिस, स्ट्रेन इंक्रीजेज मच मोर रैपिडली, वाइल इन रीजन बियॉन्ड बी से एट सी इफ द स्ट्रेचिंग फोर्स इज रिमूव द वायर डज नॉट रीगेन इट्स नेचुरल लेंथ. Length of wire changes permanently. Region beyond B is called plastic region. This we already have seen. कि B के right में जो भी region है वो plastic. If we keep on stretching the wire, a situation comes corresponding to point D, when wire begins to flow and breaks. तो यहाँ तक तो तुम force लगा रहे हो, इसके बाद wire अपने आप लंबा होता जाएगा और finally break कर जाएगा, right? तो पॉइंट डी इज कॉल्ड ब्रेकिंग स्ट्रेस और अल्टीमेट स्ट्रेस. इसके आगे वायर विल ब्रेक. बिफोर ब्रेकिंग स्ट्रेस डिक्रीजेस मोमेंटरली एज इंटरमोलिकुलर डिस्टेंसेस बिकम सो लार्ज दैट रीस्टोरिंग फोर्स बिकम्स टू स्मॉल. बिफोर ब्रेकिंग इट विल डिक्रीज अ बिट. पॉइंट ई इज कॉल्ड द फ्रैक्चर पॉइंट, जहां पे कि ब्रेक करता है. पॉइंट ई इज कॉल्ड फ्रैक्चर. Now, elastic limit, the maximum stress within which the body regains its original size and shape after the removal of deforming force is called elastic limit. So if the deforming force exceeds the elastic limit, the body acquires a permanent set or deformation and is said to be overstrained. Now ductile material, now we learn about different kind of materials, and malleable, ductile, ye sab hum log brittle, ye sab alag alag property hoti hai, inko hum log stress strain curve se samajhne ki koshish karenge. So ductile material is a material which have large plastic range. And ductile kya hua? Ductile wo hua jo ki hum wire mein hum log usko we can draw them into wire. So materials which have large plastic range of extension are called ductile material. है ना, plastic range इसका बहुत ज़्यादा होगा. ठीक है, B से लेके D तक जो portion है that is very large. So material which have large plastic range of extension are called ductile materials. So as shown in the stress strain curve shown in the figure below, their fracture point is widely separated from the elastic limit. तो इलास्टिक लिमिट से फ्रैक्चर पॉइंट इज वाइडली सेपरेटेड, राइट? सच मटेरियल अंडरगो एन इररिवर्सिबल इंक्रीज इन लेंथ बिफोर स्नैपिंग, सो दे कैन बी ड्रॉन इनटू थिन वायर्स. दैट्स व्हाई, सो डक्टिलिटी का प्रॉपर्टी है द प्रॉपर्टी बाय विच यू नो द वायर कैन बी एनी मटेरियल कैन बी ड्रॉन इनटू थिन वायर इज कॉल्ड डक्टिलिटी. सो ductile material वही होगा जिसका कि we can draw them into thin wire. For example, copper, silver, iron, aluminium are all ductile materials and which have the stress strain curve like this. You know, plastic region is very big, very high, very large. Sorry. Now comes brittle material. The material which have very small range of plastic extension are called brittle material. ठीक है, तो brittle material जो तुरंत टूट जाए तो उसका ये जो elastic limit से जो region है यहाँ से इधर, so वो so elastic limit and ये both are here only A and B. So B से लेके D तक जो breaking point वाला जो portion है वो that is very small. Okay. So such material break as soon as the stress is increased beyond the elastic limit. Their breaking point lies just close to their elastic limit, as shown in the figure below. For example, cast iron, glass, ceramics, etc. are example of brittle material. Elastic relaxation or elastic after effect, the property by virtue of which a body does not regain its original form immediately after removing the deforming force, but gains it after some time, is defined as elastic after effect or relaxation. Elastic fatigue, when a body is subjected to repeated cycles of loading and unloading, है ना, stretch करो और फिर वापस उसको original shape में लाया, फिर stretch किया, फिर लाया, तो ये बार बार जब करते हैं, it temporarily loses its property of elasticity. This is known as elastic fatigue. Temporary loss है, थोड़ी देर छोड़ देंगे तो अपने आप अपना शेप ले लेगा, इलास्टिक प्रॉपर्टी वापस आ जाएगा, बट एक ऑब्जेक्ट को बार बार हम लोग स्ट्रेच और कंप्रेस करेंगे तो अपना इलास्टिक लिमिट, इलास्टिक प्रॉपर्टी खो देगा थोड़ी देर के लिए. नाउ मेलेबिलिटी, व्हेन अ सॉलिड इज कंप्रेस्ड, अ स्टेज इज रीच्ड बियॉन्ड विच इट कैन नॉट रिकवर इट्स ओरिजिनल शेप आफ्टर द डिफॉर्मिंग फोर्स इज रिमूव्ड, दिस इज द इलास्टिक लिमिट पॉइंट ए डैश for compression, and solid then behaves like a plastic body. The yield point B dash after under compression is called crushing point. After this point, metals are said to be malleable, that is they can be hammered or rolled into thin sheets. तो जब हम लोग compress कर रहे होते हैं किसी force को लगा के elastic limit तक आएगा और उसके बाद ये जो है yield point पे पहुंच जाएगा B dash पे और उसके beyond crushing point के beyond वो मेलेबल. आफ्टर दिस स्टेज मेटल्स आर सेड टू बी मेलेबल. नाउ इलास्टोमर्स, द मटेरियल विच कैन बी इलास्टिकली स्ट्रेच्ड टू लार्ज वैल्यूज. सो मटेरियल्स विच कैन बी इलास्टिकली स्ट्रेच्ड टू लार्ज वैल्यूज ऑफ स्ट्रेन आर कॉल्ड इलास्टोमर्स. फॉर एग्जाम्पल, रबर कैन बी स्ट्रेच्ड to several times its original length, but still it can regain its original length. when the applied force is removed. So there is no well-defined plastic regions. Rubber just breaks when pulled beyond a certain limit. So its Young's modulus is very small, about 3×10⁵ Newton per meter square at slow strains. So elastic region is much in such cases is very large, but the material does not obey Hooke's law. So in our body, the elastic tissue of aorta, the large blood vessels carrying blood from the heart, is an elastomer for which the stress strain curve is shown in the figure. Now, elastic hysteresis. So elastic hysteresis, just a magnetic hysteresis, magnetize or demagnetize karte hain, to same curve nahi follow hota hai. Same yahan pe hai. Jab hum log stretch or compress karenge, to same nahi follow hoga. In most material, stress strain curve while loading and unloading do not follow same path. Jab load karte hain aur unload karte hain. So while unloading, stress decreases faster than strain. Okay. So jab load kar rahe hote hain, tab aise jayega. और जब अनलोड करेंगे तो दैट विल बी फास्टर. ठीक है. सो व्हाइल अनलोडिंग स्ट्रेस डिक्रीजेस फास्टर देन स्ट्रेन, इन अदर वर्ड स्ट्रेस लैग्स बिहाइंड द स्ट्रेन. ठीक है, सॉरी, स्ट्रेन लैग्स बिहाइंड द स्ट्रेस, है ना.
एक्सक्यूज मी सर.
हाँ जी
सर, इसमें भी वैसे होता है कि जैसे सर उसमें था कि हिस्टेरेसिस लूप जो है नैरो होता है, एक बार कुछ के लिए वो widen हो जाता है hysteresis loop.
हाँ, यहाँ पे भी अलग-अलग material के लिए अलग-अलग follow होगा ना. ठीक है. The lagging of strain behind the stress is defined as elastic hysteresis. Work done while loading is not fully recovered while unloading. Some of the energy is lost. Energy कितना loss होगा, ये जो area है इसके area के बराबर. ठीक है. So we can draw stress strain curve while loading as well as while unloading of a given sample. For material showing hysteresis curves while loading and unloading do not match. Now, hysteresis loop, for material showing hysteresis, stress strain curve for complete cycle of loading and unloading forms a closed loop. This loop is called hysteresis loop. Area enclosed by hysteresis loop is numerically equal to energy lost per unit volume per cycle. Materials having large area of hysteresis loop are used to absorb vibration of the machinery, as vibrational energy will be converted into heat. Material A having more area of loop is suitable for this purpose. Hysteresis loop of car tires should have small area like material B so that they do not get heated up excessively. Now, fourth one is elastic restoring force are strictly conservative only when the elastic hysteresis is zero. That is, the loading and unloading stress strain curves are identical. The material which have low elastic hysteresis also has also low elastic relaxation time. Now, breaking stress. So stress beyond which material breaks is called the breaking stress or the ultimate strength. So breaking stress is breaking force by area of cross section. So breaking force is breaking stress into area of cross section. Breaking stress depends on nature of material, temperature, and impurities. Breaking stress does not depend on cross-sectional area or thickness, applied force. Third, breaking force or maximum load force that can be applied on the wire depends on cross-sectional area or thickness, nature of material, temperature, and impurities. Now some questions. A 1000 kg lift is tied with a metallic wire of maximum safe stress of 1.4. So the maximum stress a wire can take is 1.4×10⁸ Newton per meter square. If the maximum acceleration of the lift is 1.2 meter per second square, then the minimum diameter of the wire is given as, so see, if we have this lift is going up 10 cm, iska weight mg, aur ye upar ja raha hai a acceleration, so ye kya ho jayega, t minus mg is equal to ma, or T is equal to mg plus ma or T is equal to m times g plus a. तो ऊपर जो जाएगा a acceleration से है ना, so maximum tension T maximum is equal to mass 1000 into g plus a 9.8 plus 1.2. So this is 11,000 newton. So this is the maximum tension. Now, stress upon strain. So stress is equal to deforming force F upon A. So maximum tension is 11,000 newton divided by area, that is pi r square. We have to find the diameter of the wire. Stress de rakha hai 1.4 into 10 to the power 8 is equal to 11,000 divided by 22 by 7 into r square. R square is 11,000 into 7 by 22, 1.4, 10 to the power 8. R square ho gaya, or 25 10 to the power minus 6. So R will be equal to 5 into 10 to the power minus 3. And diameter is equal to 2R, 10 into 10 to the power minus 3 or 10 to the power minus 2, 0.01 meter ho gaya, option 3. Done?
Yes, sir.
Now in this question, are two blocks of masses 1 kg and 2 kg are connected by a metal wire going over a smooth pulley as shown in the figure. तो ये एक ब्लॉक और ये दूसरा ब्लॉक और साथ में ये मेटल वायर से कनेक्टेड है going over a smooth pulley. Now the breaking stress of the metal is 2 into 10 to the power 9. ये पावर में है 10 to the power 9. 2 into 10 to the power 9 newton per meter square. What should be the minimum radius of the wire used if it is not to break? अब देखो ये इधर जाएगा, ये ऊपर जाएगा, ये नीचे आएगा a acceleration से, इधर जाएगा a acceleration से. So मान लो tension T है, यहाँ पे tension T है, force यहाँ 1g लग रहा है, यहाँ पे 2g लग रहा है. So that means 2g minus T is equal to 2a and T minus 1g is equal to 1a. Add कर देंगे, so 2g minus 1g, so g is equal to 3a or a is equal to g by 3. So that is 10 by 3 meter per second square. So isse jo tension T hai, T is equal to G plus is G by 3, 4G by 3, or T is equal to 40 by 3 Newton. A breaking stress T upon A is equal to 40 by 3 into pi r square is equal to 2 into 10 to the power 9. So 40 by 3 into 22 by 7 into 2 into 10 to the power 9 is equal to r square.
Yes, sir.
So this is 70 by 33 into 10 to the power 9 is r square. So r square is 70 by 33. -9. R will be equal to 1.45 × 10⁻³. So this is the minimum radius. Is it clear?
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
Now Hooke's law we studied earlier also. Within elastic limit, stress is directly proportional to strain. Okay? So jab within elastic limit, stress is directly proportional to strain. So stress by strain is a constant. That constant is called elastic constant or modulus of elasticity of the substance. So Hooke's law states that stress upon strain is equal to constant, or E usko modulus of elasticity kehte hain. E is known as modulus of elasticity. Now like Boyle's law, Hooke's law is one of the earliest quantitative relationship in science. Hooke's law is valid only in linear position of the stress strain curve. This law is not valid for large values of strain. The volume of modulus of elasticity depends the value of the value of modulus of elasticity depends on the type of material and temperature. It does not depend upon the value of stress and strain. Okay. SI unit of modulus of elasticity is Newton per meter square. Its dimensional formula is ML minus 1 T minus 2. Now, types of modulus of elasticity. First is Young's modulus of elasticity, bulk modulus of elasticity, and modulus of rigidity. So Young's modulus of elasticity is represented by capital Y. Bulk modulus of elasticity is generally represented by capital B, and modulus of rigidity is represented by eta. Now, Young's modulus of elasticity, it is represented by capital Y. So within elastic limit, elastic stress and longitudinal stress and longitudinal strain are constant in ratio, which is called Young's modulus. So Young's modulus, Y is equal to longitudinal stress upon longitudinal strain. So longitudinal stress is F upon A, longitudinal strain is delta L upon L. So Y is equal to Young's modulus is longitudinal stress upon longitudinal strain. So Y is equal to F upon A divided by delta L upon L. So see, F upon A into L delta L. So F into L by A delta L. Okay. So this is your, sorry, F into L by A delta L. If we have to find a delta L, in that case, this will be F into L by A into Y. Also, F can be found as AY delta L divided by L. Okay. So you just remember one formula, this longitudinal stress upon longitudinal strain. Y is equal to FL by A delta L. Ye yaad rakhenge to isse se. So you just need to remember this. Now SI unit of Young's modulus is Newton per meter square. Okay. क्योंकि स्ट्रेस का ही बस लेंगे, स्ट्रेन का तो कोई यूनिट होता नहीं है. स्ट्रेस अपॉन स्ट्रेन हम कहते हैं. इफेक्ट ऑफ टेम्परेचर ऑन वाई, व्हेन टेम्परेचर इज इंक्रीज इलास्टिक प्रॉपर्टी इन जनरल डिक्रीजेस, दैट इज इलास्टिक कांस्टेंट डिक्रीजेस. सो प्लास्टिसिटी इंक्रीजेस विद इन विथ टेम्परेचर. इफेक्ट ऑफ इम्प्योरिटीज ऑन वाई, वाई इज स्लाइटली इंक्रीज्ड बाय इम्प्योरिटी, है ना. The intermolecular attraction force inside wire effectively increases by impurity. Due to this, external force can be easily opposed, defined only for solid and not for liquid or gases. For a special kind of steel, elastic constants do not vary appreciably with temperature. This steel is called inverse steel. So we'll stop here, and इसके आगे हम लोग नेक्स्ट क्लास में करेंगे. इज इट क्लियर? सो बेसिकली वी विल स्टार्ट विद न्यूमेरिकल्स इन द नेक्स्ट क्लास. यंग्स मॉडुलस पे जो भी न्यूमेरिकल्स है, कुछ 5-6 क्वेश्चंस करेंगे एंड देन वी कैन प्रोसीड फर्दर. क्लियर है बच्चों?
थैंक यू सो मच.